Hello, my name is William Osmond, and on today's episode of Crappy Science, we'll be looking into alternative methods of popping popcorn, because one day your microwave might be full of bees! And then what are you going to do? You're going to use your laser cutter to pop that popcorn. Now, this is thanks to a user suggestion by whose name I have no idea how to pronounce, so here's a text to speech converter we found online.
Mr. Blaylock.
Anyways, this user suggestion could just be a front for my blatant plagiarism of Cody's lab, where he used a handheld tiny laser to try and pop popcorn, but ended up just burning straight through it. So I'm not sure why my laser, which is about 100 times more powerful, would work. I'm just adding stuff right now, because I don't know how long this video is going to be, and so this will just allow us to fluff that thing up right now to a full-size length video. Thank you. In the name of crappy science, we're going to use some microwavable popcorn, and we did a control test to make sure it's actually going to pop by putting it in a pan on the stove. Now, the laser will heat the kernel evenly, which is the key point, because you don't want to burn through the shell, which will crack it and relieve the pressure when it tries to pop, which is the problem Cody had, because his laser was too tiny or too small of an energy density, or too high of an energy density. So this laser, we have a lens on it, which will allow us to defocus the beam so we have less dense energy, and it won't burn the shell, hopefully. Yeah, it's like half popped. No good. Yeah, I'm eating it. It's going down. Since we're not actually cutting anything, I don't think there will be a lot of smoke produced, so I'm not going to hook the ventilation up. I'm probably going to regret this and have to hook the ventilation up, but we are going to use compressed air to push air out the nozzle to keep the nozzle clear. I just decided maybe we try this one without compressed air and see what happens. Maybe I'll just put a light cross breeze by blowing on it, and hopefully that keeps the smoke from going up. I'm feeling extra lazy today. Okay, 3, 2, 1, fire. Wow, that went right through. 2, 1, fire. 2, 1. The laser pierces the kernel almost instantly. To get an idea of how much the beam has defocused, we can put a piece of wood under and just burn it really quick and see how big the spot size is. So it's a little bigger than a kernel, so we probably want to go even lower. We can try it. Should we try it? What do you think, cameraman John? Now these have a lot of oil on them, which I actually think is not a good thing, but we'll see what happens. I think the oil, like the grease on them, is just gonna smoke a bunch. Look at that. Nice popcorn. Burnt corn. Crispy corn. Charcoal corn. Oh my god, no! Charcoal corn. Wow! Let's open a window. Okay, I've lowered the power significantly, and we're gonna try and cook it now. It's still too much. It smells like popcorn. It doesn't smell totally burnt. I mean, it's definitely totally burnt, but it looks like we broke the kernel. We moved the cutting surface a little further down. Too much trash under here. So the beam should hopefully have a wider swath, or a wider whatever. Let's just see what it looks like now. It's about the size of a dime, a little smaller than a dime. Damn it, get off. No, uh-oh. No, don't fall through. We messed it up already. Now we'll try some pulsing power. It just burst?
It burst.
This life hack isn't going as well as I originally planned. The kernel isn't absorbing the heat evenly, and so it seems to be kind of cracking and popping at the top, but not popping what you'd expect popcorn to do. So I've got an idea. Let's put it on a little motor and spin it underneath the laser, and hopefully we can evenly heat it. I'm gonna cut a little piece of brass tube with my dollar store hacksaw. I'm gonna squeeze the brass tube a little bit so we can stick the kernels of corn in. And then I'm going to crimp the little shaft, or the pipe, onto the motor shaft. Ta-da! Motor is on, and laser is on. Oh, look, it's like swelling up. I think. Come on. Oh, yes! Oh my god, yes! I can't believe that worked. That's so cool. You can see like where the kernel was inside the tube, it didn't pop. It just completely blew out the front. But after like 4 or 5 fails, I'm super excited to actually have like pop the popcorn with the laser in like an actual popcorn-looking popcorn. Tastes like popcorn. All right, let's set up a second kernel. So you kind of got to be picky with which kernels you choose because they're all different sizes. There we go. Yes. Oh my god, that's so much fun. I feel like I have like some sort of success in my life. I was up all night making popcorn.
with our rotary attachment, it works pretty well. It takes like 20 to 30 seconds per kernel. I didn't want to show you the whole thing because it's pretty boring. Now, thanks to my little cousin Liam from this delightful cat shirt. And if you have a suggestion for a laser cutting experiment, leave it in the comments below, because this video would not have happened without a user suggestion. Could be you next. See ya.